Hello everyone, this year keeps on giving in terms of vulnerability. We're here with another major vulnerability, MongoBleed, that has been disclosed as a gift to all of us over Christmas. Now, the exploitation over Christmas, and now is almost the 31st of December, is the end of the year, and the exploitations keep on ramping up. We have disclosed the vulnerability, the exploitation, the patching methods, but I wanted to spend a little bit of time to explain why this vulnerability is bad, even though it's not a remote code execution, and how it resembles Heartbleed. That was another similar vulnerability that disclosed memory selection, and why you should care about this particular vulnerability. But without further ado, let's dig into the blog and the exploit, and then I'm gonna walk you through the actual how to simulate the exploit and how to verify if your system are compromised or non-compromised. Let's dig in. What is MongoBleed? MongoBleed is a memory leak. It's not a remote code execution. It means that you can't just send a simple string to exploit like we've seen in React to Shell in few weeks, months ago, depending on when you are tuning in this particular vulnerability. Why is it particularly dangerous? Well, because it's fairly easy to exploit in terms of vulnerability, and we've seen a fairly large amount of exploitation as well as system expose. I'm going to dig into that. What you have to do to fix this, upgrade the version or limit the zlib compression library, but that's just a workaround. There are several versions affected by this vulnerability, from 8.2 all the way to the legacy and the end of life. So suggestion is to move to a newer version, and specific to this, the online version of this particular vulnerability is already being patched even before release of the official advisory. MongoDB has released a full, let's accept the cookie, a full remediation step for their version. But as I mentioned, the vulnerable version was already patched before the release of the advisory on the 24th of January. Just a little bit of a Christmas gift. But as I mentioned, you can craft a specific message that targets the zlibc compression methods, fundamentally requesting a section of the memory by fundamentally compromising how this parser works. So you ask a section of data and you actually ended up requesting or sending less data. So the system actually triggered a read of more data than it was originally exploited. And that's fundamentally, without digging deeper in how the exploit work, how the exploit kind of trigger, by playing on this delta of memory and playing on the system that actually stream and read the memory and unpackage the memory. Now, the note is there is no crash, there is no bleed out, there is no information that this has been triggered and the returning data has been provided to a particular attacker. So that's the particular element that is dangerous for this vulnerability, because as defender, it's difficult to detect when this vulnerability has been triggered. Now, how you will see and what is culprit of this vulnerability, there are the specific amount pieces of code in the blog. I'm not going to dig too much into this, but you can review those specific pieces of code. But this is how the information were returned in that particular function and how the parsing string was affected. And all of this, as I mentioned, is on the compressor and how this was originally detected. So you can see and dig deeper into the particular vulnerability and into the particular code that was vulnerable. Now, there is an exploit available. We developed our own version of lab so that you can test the exploit and scanners between code scanning and exploit vulnerability scanning so that you can test your own system. As I mentioned before, there are 213,000 servers affected by this version, with the 7x and the 8x to be the one more frequent across all of these various versions. 7x, as I mentioned, is the most frequent one. And the way you would address this, you will notice specific element, like specific data leaking out, not from the server, but on the system around your server, or spike of memory, because reading specific chunk of memory, considering this will be sequentialized as a type of attack, because the attacker will not get credentials or keys or particular juicy information from the get-go. So you will see a spike in the server activity. And as remediation, please patch this system. There is a particular string that you might be able to detect, but that's a temporary workaround, or even disabling the zlib C compressor on MongoDB could be a temporary workaround. Patching is always the best way because you remove the problem altogether and the change is fairly straightforward. Now, without further ado, let's dig into the vulnerability. All right, so if you go inside the exploit section of the MongoDB or MongoBleed exploit GitHub that you can see in the article and in the comment, fundamentally, you can get into the script, launch Docker Compose. This will launch two versions of MongoDB, vulnerable version of Docker, one that is patched and one that is vulnerable. You can see them, both of them here. You can verify that MongoDB is actually running and on which port they're both running. And then you can launch the first version of MongoDB. Now the 18 will be fixed, so the vulnerability will not trigger in this particular instance. As you can see, there is no leak memory. Now you can target a local host or you can target your local system to verify that you have been patched. So this will be the exploit. Now, because this is a dangerous exploit that could potentially compromise your keys, please use this verification system at your own expense. We take absolutely no responsibility for this POC available, but please use this only on your lab system. Now the 17, as you can see, we start receiving from the shell detail about the memory leak, and indeed this particular version of MongoDB is vulnerable. And as you can see here, you can see the various versions of the leak and the pieces of memory that was leaked. Now the lab allows you to play a little bit. With the range of memory that you wanna get and extract. But again, just to verify that different pieces of memory, or you can force the system to access different pieces of memory. But again, please use this as in your own server or not basically for nefarious. Now, currently there are different instances. As I say, the 8 and the 7 are the one that are more frequent across the world. So it's a quite easy to exploit, as you can see, and widespread vulnerability. So please, if you have a vulnerable server, patch it as soon as possible. Now, you can scan your external facing system or your internal facing system with commands similar to the lab, and the lab result could send potentially the data to Phoenix to actually identify that this particular version is vulnerable. To send to Phoenix the result that this particular version is vulnerable. The alternative way is to scan a sample of your vulnerability file or Docker file to detect at scale if you have this particular version of the vulnerability. And this you can also send with this particular command the findings on Phoenix. Of course, you need to have a Phoenix config file with your API credential. What that does is fundamentally it enables you to see the vulnerability result inside Phoenix, see the detail from a researcher who could be the potential threat actor that could leverage this vulnerability, launch the researcher agent to detect the detail of this vulnerability that you require. And on the blog, there is a campaign that enabled you to fundamentally look at how widespread this particular vulnerability is in your system and how many vulnerable systems you have. Now, the campaign has already all of the description and the detail, IOC, and a way to detect fundamentally this vulnerability. Again, it's fairly hard to detect, but it's fairly easy to patch, low maintenance, and the attack is fairly easy to execute. The alternative way is to search for the MongoDB instance in this bomb section of Phoenix Security and see if you have a vulnerable version or not. The vulnerability will be attached, of course, in here as well. Just notify you that the vulnerability is there and is executable. Now, as I said, the vulnerability, as per shutdown detail, is quite widespread. So please make sure that you have your system patched and you're not vulnerable to this particular version of MongoBleed. It's fairly easy to execute. It doesn't require remote code execution, but as you can see, it's fairly easy to execute different version of the vulnerability. Stay safe out there. This is Francesco Cipollone with Phoenix Security Research. I'm the CEO and co-founder. Stay safe out there, patch your system, and have a happy new year. Hopefully we'll have a more quiet New Year's. Goodbye.